Hello, good morning. Welcome to another KAC video devotionals for seniors. My name is Oni Elizabeth. Today is the 19th of February, and today we'll be looking at the topic, how to figure out things you don't know in relationship and life. Jeremiah 33, verse 1 to 3, KJV translation. Moreover, the word of the Lord came unto Jeremiah the second time, while he was yet shut up in the court of the prison, saying, Thus saith the Lord, the maker thereof, the Lord that formed it to establish it, the Lord is his name. Call unto me, and I will answer thee, and show thee great and mighty things, which thou knowest not. This is what I love about God's word. The word of the Lord came unto Jeremiah. Here it is like saying a human being walked up to you, but actually God's word is more tangible than a human being. The word of God is life. It is life, and it is the source of every life. It is the same word that became flesh and dwelt among us. You see, the word of God will always come, and that is the beginning of good things in your life and the end of unpalatable experiences. The word of the Lord, let it come unto you today before you leave your room, before you step out into your daily endeavors. It is the secret of life. Before you see the dawn of day and step out into the early morning sunshine, let the word of God light your soul in its blazing Shekinah glory. And you see, the word of God was not just coming unto Jeremiah. The scripture says it came unto him the second time. God is a God of the second chance, and the third chance, and the fourth chance, and until you get it, he will come to you again and again because of his loving kindness and mercy. To you out there reading this, don't back out on God, for he will lovingly embrace you when you respond to his word. You are not too far gone. Don't allow the devil to deceive you. God will embrace the vilest of sinners that come unto him and wash them clean as white as snow. I love this. While he was yet shut up in the court of the prison, the word of God is not location limited or circumstance hindered. It does not discriminate, and it does not play politics. It is not partial or biased. There is no distance in the realm of the spirit. The word came unto Jeremiah while he was still locked up. Do you feel locked up and confused in a relationship or marriage? Do you feel barred and busted? The word of the Lord is what will free you, for you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. In that situation that looks very bleak, what you need to get in that situation that looks very bleak, what you need to get you out is the word of God. In those situations, the last thing your flesh wants to do is to read or study God's word. Your flesh wants to panic, cry, gossip, rant, complain, and play the blame game. It wants to get depressed and have some pity party. But you see, in such situations, you cannot allow your body to dictate to you. You must put your body under by diving into God's word to hear what he will say unto you. You see, whatever you are facing right now, whatever imbroglio you find yourself, whatever relationship issue or marriage pressure that faces you, one thing guaranteed to sort you out is God's word. And that word will come unto you wherever you are. Joseph was in prison until the word of God tried him. The word will dissolve every puzzle and unravel every enigma. You are confused as to the choice of who to marry. Get back into God's word, for in him is life, and the life is the light of men. The light gives you energy to go the way that the light will show you. Verse 3 says, Call unto me, I will answer thee, and show thee great and mighty things, which thou knowest not. Message translation says, Jeremiah 33, verse 3, message translation, Call to me, and I will answer you. I will tell you marvelous and wondrous things that you would never figure out on your own. You see, there are things about your life, relationship, and marriage that you can never figure out on your own. You don't often see beyond your nose. Your sight is often terminated by the horizon. There are deceivers. A handsome man is not always a God-loving man. A rich man is not always a nice man. A wicked man can be mercifully cruel. A beautiful woman can be a strange woman. The Bible talks about beautiful faces on an empty head. How do you figure out some of these things? The first thing is that the word of God must come unto you. The second thing is that you learn to call unto him and he will answer you. The question is, will it be that easy? Just call on him, and then the next thing is that he will answer. This is the way I want you to say it. When you call a stranger, you introduce yourself first. When you call a friend, he already has your number. And sometimes, you don't even greet him or her before you say what you want to say. The scripture above is obviously one of a friendship, a relationship with God. Call unto me and I will answer. He didn't say, call unto me and introduce yourself, and then I will consult my angels to find out who you are. It's just like, call unto me and I will answer. Why? The background is that the word of God already came unto you. There is already a relationship. It is on that premises that you call unto him and he will answer you. I pray for you this morning that even as you read this, the word of the Lord will come unto you to lift you out of every miry clay and set your foot upon the mountain. You will overcome that challenge by the word of God. You will not be caught up in the midst of your days. The very help you need this day, God's word will bring it unto you. Stop crying, wipe the tears off, and get into God's word. Meditation for the day. In the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word was God. John 1 verse 1, KJV translation. Prayer for the day. O Lord, make me a student of the word. Prayer 2. My Father, help me to overcome every challenge on my way to greatness. Prayer 3. Father, send help my way. Confession for the day. I am a lover of God's word. I study God's word. I am addicted to the word. The word of God is light to me. I am not confused. Illumination comes to my path. The word is coming to me. It addresses my situation. God is lifting me up. He is placing my foot upon the solid rock. The help of God locates me today and always. Action plan for the day. Get into God's word.
We'd like you to partner with us in Cases in Us Club. To do so, kindly use the banking information you see on the screen. And for international giving, please navigate to the URL you see on the screen at casesandus.com/give. God bless you as you do so. This devotional is taken from our books for single married, and these books are available on Amazon and on Kada Books. In order to access the books, kindly navigate to the URL you see on the screen at casesandus.com/books. If you live in the city of Ibadan, we'd like you to worship with us at Shouts of Grace Center. It's at Joker Plaza, beside Trans Amusement Park, Bodija UI Road, in the city of Ibadan. On Sundays, we have two services by 7:30 and 9 o'clock, and by Wednesdays, 6 p.m. It will be our pleasure to have you. Kindly follow us on Cases and Us Club at casesandus.com. You'll have a lot of resources for your soul.